FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. It's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Washington football team taking on the Cincinnati Bengals.
Well, we've had spotty showers since about 7 a.m. here in D.C., and the radar indicates it's going to continue, but nothing to stop football from happening at FedEx Field. The enthusiasm for football here on the East Coast always in the air. These folks are ready as their guys get set to match up with the Cincinnati Bengals. Welcome again, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and yes, the rain is falling now, and it is supposed to continue to fall throughout this game. So how do you think that will impact this contest?
Well, first and foremost, both quarterbacks are going to make sure the officials have those dry footballs coming in each and every play and standing over them sometimes with a towel before the center gets up there to snap it. Second thing is the focus of all the guys who handle the football. Do they wear gloves? Do they take them off? Will they carry the ball high and tight to make sure they have good ball security? That's paramount in a game like this.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Here are the Bengals on offense, and here is Joe Burrow ready to lead them at quarterback.
And this could be a whole lot of fun because if his game plan goes into effect early, we're going to see some shots downfield, aren't we? What did he talk to us about? Stretching the field. Wants to open things up for not just his receivers, but for anything underneath.
Well, that was the theme, the front page of the sports section, where the columnists write, possible air raid. So we'll see.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how the coaches view that, right? What? Who gave away the game plan? I think it's pretty obvious, though. That'll help them win.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw.
Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And he bats it away and it falls down incomplete.
He was looking for Trent Taylor there. That'll bring up second down.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
Burrow once again here on second and 10. Wide open receiver complete. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. 25 yards there on the catch and run. First down,
Cincinnati. They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
In Washington territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Well, it's almost football 101 that you preach to your safeties. Don't let anyone get behind you to the last line of defense. But he didn't let the play come to him. He went to the play. How about that read and recognition and finishing off that one behind the line of scrimmage?
An extra man in the secondary for Washington on third down. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. That's complete to the tight end Sample. And he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Kevin, so on fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Steven Sims set to return it for Washington. And here's a very low-line drive, almost whiffed on it.
Washington takes over.
So out comes the Washington offense onto the field. They'll be led out by their 6-1 quarterback from Old Dominion. It's Taylor Heinicke.
And what I enjoyed in preparing for this game was talking not just with the coaching staff, but with him as well. And I found it interesting that the coaching staff sees him one way, and he sees himself an entirely different way.
Yeah, one thing he said he's always working on, we know he's not bad at this, but his footwork, always wants to improve that, and that's something he's going to focus on here.
And what was so funny, what did the offensive coordinator say right off the top? He's got great footwork. Love his footwork. So this guy is never satisfied.
They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Brings up second.
Well, I sure wouldn't be surprised if we see more of this as this game goes on, because we know they like to use their wideouts either on quick throws or on jet sweeps like what we just saw there. And to say that that one worked well, partner, that's stating the obvious.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And he'll take this down inside the 15-yard line. Well, certainly not how he wanted to start his night. First throw of the game, an INT.
Yeah, it's not easy, but he's got to try and wipe that one away from the memory banks. And let's face it, it's not often a quarterback and a defensive back have a lot in common. But one thing, because they have these individual-type plays, they've got to have short memories, don't they? DB gets beat, wipe it away, quarterback throws a pick, has to do the same thing.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. This one hauled in by Sample. And he's taken down at the 7 after a gain of 7.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Second down and 3, ball on the 7. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. And they went empty backfield, and because of that, nobody was there to pick up the blitz.
And you know that offenses, when they go with the empty backfield, they have different things designed on every play to try to account for things. But what people often forget, defense is audible as well. And a lot of times when they see an empty backfield, they audible right into a blitzing situation.
Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on 3rd and 8. Now it's Burrow. This will be caught at about the 5. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches. They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. And that is going to be incomplete. The Bengals try it, but it doesn't work out. And that will force a turnover on downs. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. Doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
They'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a game.
The last run got six, now second and four. Now Heinicke got a man open. It's Ricky Seals-Jones. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. 12 yards there and a first down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
A run here for J.D. McKissic. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards. Now after that last play, there's a Bengal down on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The pickup of four. Here's second and six. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. Give him 3 on the play, and they're going to have a third down.
That's a gain of 3. Brings up 3rd and 3.
Throw here, out of the gun. He finds Humphreys. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
1st and 10 at the 41-yard line. That's the end of the first quarter.
We're scoreless after one. Second quarter now from our nation's capital, and it's Washington in possession of the football as they've got it with a 1st and 10. It's McKissic. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Now an option play on 2nd down. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. He could muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a 3rd and very short. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Got an open man, finds Gibson.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll make it a second down.
They're on the tackle. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the 44-yard line.
Now a throw here, hauled in. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
56 to Mike, boy, 56. Shut
up. And now he'll tuck it and run. And he'll be taken down at the 34. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Second and 8.
It's incomplete.
He's trying to get it to Terry McLaurin. And that takes us from second to third down.
Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. They'll look to throw. He sets to fire deep. Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is third down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
Cincinnati set to take over once again.
And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzomah.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Now Burrow to throw on second down. Throw right side into the hands of the tight end Sample. The ball comes out, and it's Washington that scoops it up.
And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
All these years we've been watching the game, I start to get the sense that whenever it rains out, those guys who have to touch the ball and carry it, they're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy I'm not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now it's Barber. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. And now time will be called here as Washington has an injured player down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Washington with their first trip to the red zone thus far. This is first and goal from about the 8. Gonna give this time to the tailback. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
Kareem on the tackle. A 4-yard gain brings up second and goal at the Bengals.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll check in with our Jonathan Coachman. He'll have highlights and analysis of the first half, and our highlights will likely be on the defensive. And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Larry Ogunjobi, the defensive tackle, getting in there for a loss of 5.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And that'll bring up fourth down as his Cincy defense stands up on third.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
So now on fourth down, Washington will hand things over to their kicker, Dustin Hopkins. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Hopkins' kick is good. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0.
Bengals nothing.
So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game, because anytime you get to the red zone and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there and then you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
Dustin Hopkins.
Following the made field goal for 3, Hopkins now to kick it off. Now it's Wilson. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 26.
Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown, but they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
They will throw on first down with Burrow toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Drew Sample, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Now left side on the swing pass. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts as he'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. He was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
And a fair catch taken back near about the 35, 36-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. He personally is playing poorly, but the bottom line is his team's winning. He probably feels, oh, hey, if I can right the ship, we can really extend this lead.
Just try and get back to being the player he knows he can be and continuing to be the leader that he has to be. Doesn't matter whether he's playing real well or not. When you're winning the game, everything's good. Really, you got to treat it like it's sunshine. Hey, everything's great. That's what he has continued to do, and I'm with you. He wants to play better to make sure he's a part of it.
He wants to flip those interceptions and touchdown numbers. Two INTs, no touchdowns.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to go for a big play down. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Catch is made. It's Harmon. And they move this all the way down to the 9. 25 yards that time.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Yeah, he's got it. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. 56. Complete with 11 seconds remaining now.
The sideline and incomplete. It's now third and goal.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. They'll look to throw again. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. Adam Humphries in the final seconds of the first half. And Washington going to add on to their lead.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Well, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And the result, a touchdown for Washington. So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. The return man, Wilson. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
Reason to do anything foolish as they'll snap it one more time on first down. He'll take the knee and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we have reached halftime with our score 10-0. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in everyone to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We saw a strong first half from our quarterback. His guys lead it by 10 as we send it back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Gentlemen.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Danny Johnson returning. And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call. Well, that holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
When the holding penalty sets him back inside the 20 as they get going on this drive. They go play action here on first down. This is caught by his tight end, Logan Thomas. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 16 yards right off the bat with a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. A carry now for McKissick.
J.D. McKissic.
A gain of three, second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 44-yard line.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. And he'll give it here to his running back. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41.
Ball carrier.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They'll run with McKissic. And he is going to be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bengals 35. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They'll look to throw for it on third and one. And he finds Seals Jones complete. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 12-yard line. Forget the run on third and one. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Circle round twice for the encore.
In the third quarter here in D.C., a second and 10 upcoming. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of six as he gets halfway to the goal line. They get six. That'll leave him with third and four.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and four. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that'll bring up fourth down as his Cincy defense stands up on third.
Brandon, some of those windows to throw the football that exists when you're between the 20s, they don't exist when you're this close to the goal line. But as a former DB, I liked it closer to the goal line. Tighter windows made it easier to cover people, actually.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Hopkins' kick is good. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0.
Bengals nothing.
So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're really excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
Following the made field goal for three, Hopkins now to kick it off. Now it's Wilson. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
The Bengals take over first and 10. At their
so here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. From the gun, he'll set up to throw. His throw incomplete. Tyler Boyd, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. He's got his man, Boyd. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Burrow to Boyd there for the Cincy first. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
On first and 10, Joe Burrow. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line, tackled there. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. From the gun, a give to Mixon. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Third down, Burrow. Throw left side, complete. That's Boyd. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain. Back now at FedEx Field. It's the Bengals. They've got the football, but they trail here as we get rolling in quarter number 4. They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. And no, it's incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And Washington will have it on the turnover on downs. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. A good starting spot for Washington as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Pop free. We could hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to the fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on him.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them to start to make a comeback.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Now Heineke, that's complete, middle of the field to Humphreys. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 38. Now a handoff here to his running back. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Mike Hilton, and he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. That is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. The interception was a great starting point, but now they need points pretty quickly, down two scores. Very good starting field position for the Bengals here as they come up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. And here's a throw taken in by Boyd. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. From midfield now, Burrow firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Even though this offense doesn't have a single point to its name, they're not totally out of this game yet. A touchdown here, they could be in business.
And how about that last play? Now they've got momentum going, so you know I'm a big advocate. Get back on the line of scrimmage. Throw another play at them while you've got them rocked on their heels.
Now Burrow on first down. Going to throw right side here, complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. This duo locked in, 14 yards there, and a first down. Throwing again, it's Burrow. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Jet sweep, Boyd with it. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, we've seen running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved in the running game.
And that is something we are seeing more and more in this league, no question about it. That wasn't the biggest of gains, but it was enough to get him a first down. And it continues to test the defense.
And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And his throw here is incomplete. Trent Taylor, the one he was looking for. And it's 3rd down.
Had an open man that time, man. They're putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. 7th play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on 3rd down. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a 1-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And that'll make it 13-7. So that drive takes them down the field in 8 plays. And it ends with a Bengals score. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. Johnson now returning. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
Washington takes over 1st and 10.
Now we get another look at Washington on offense. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all 3 timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. McKissick, and he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. The Bengals going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important 3rd down.
Shut up!
man out of the backfield. That's complete. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And they take a knee. Second down, it's Gibson, and to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you watch high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Washington about to close this one out as they are down to a knee.
Tonight.
So a victory here for the Washington football team. And they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
Just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Washington football team as we say so long from FedEx Field.